Hello everyone, welcome to Indian Judicial Service. Today we are taking question number 176 to 200. This is the part 8 of top 300 MCQ of Indian Evidence Act 1872. And if you like this video, please click on like button and share this video to your friends and who are preparing for judicial examination and other law related examination. And don't forget to subscribe our channel. Now without wasting your time, we are starting here. Question number 176. Presumption under section 113A of Evidence Act can be raised if a suicide by the married woman is committed within 7 years of marriage, within 5 years of marriage, within 3 years of marriage, within 1 year of marriage. So here answer is within 7 years of marriage. According to section 113A of Evidence Act, the right if the suicide by a married woman is committing within the 7 years of marriage. Question number 177. The presumption as to a dowry death contained in, so option A 111A of Evidence Act, 113A of Evidence Act, 113B of Evidence Act, 113 of Evidence Act. So here answer is option C, 113 of B of Evidence Act. Question number 178. Presumption under section 114 of Evidence Act can be raised having regard to the common course of natural event, human conduct, public and private business, all of the above. So here answer all of the above. Section 114, the provided that the courts may presume existence of certain fact. So these are the certain facts here: natural event, human conduct, public or private conduct. So here answer all of the above. Question number 179, the doctrine of estoppel is contained in section 115 of Evidence Act, 114 of Evidence Act, 113 of Evidence Act, 112 of Evidence Act. So it is clear here, doctrine of estoppel is available in section 115 of Evidence Act. Option A is correct here. Question number 180, the doctrine of estoppel is a substantive law, rule of equity, rule of evidence, law of pleading. So it is clear here, it is law of evidence. In according to common law, it was a rule of equity, but now it is rule of evidence. In some time the MCQ given that the doctrine of estoppel is substantive law, procedural law, rule of equity and law of pleading. So in that time we are choosing law of equity, but if there is available the option rule of evidence, so we should taking here option C is correct here, the rule of evidence. Doctrine of estoppel is a rule of evidence. Question number 181, estoppel are binding upon litigating parties upon a privy of a litigating parties. Upon stranger to the list and both A and B. So here answer both option D is correct, both A and B. What is here both A and B? So estoppel binding litigating party and upon a privy of litigating parties. Question number 182. The estoppel is a rule of civil action, criminal action, both civil and criminal action, only B, not A. So here answer is the estoppel is a rule of civil action. Estoppel can be by matter of record resulting from the judgment of a competent court, by deed resulting from entering into a solemn engagement as a certain fact, by the peace rising from agreement or contact from act or conduct of misrepresentation resulting in a change of position, all of the above. So here answer all of the above. The estoppel can be matter of record, deal with resulting from entering into the solemn agreement, engagement, the PS arising from agreement, of a contract, and from act conducted the misrepresentation resulting the change of position. Question number 84. The estoppel in section 115 of Evidence Act is an estoppel by record, is an estoppel by deed, is an estoppel by peace, and all of the above. So here answer is option C is correct. Here is an estoppel by peace. Question number 185. Which of the following R is no estoppel on a point of law against the statute, attestation of a deed, all of the above? So here answer is attestation of deed. Estoppel can be by silence, negligence, election, all of the above. So here answer all of the above. Estoppel can be by silence, negligence, or election. Question number 187. Estoppel deed with question of fact, question of right, both A and B, neither A nor B. So here estoppel deal with question of fact. Question number 188. Is a cause of action in itself create a cause of action? Both A and B are correct. Neither A nor B is correct. So here answer is neither A nor B is correct. Estoppel is cause of action itself and create a cause of action. So both are wrong here. Neither A nor B. Option question number 189. Estoppel should be specifically pleaded, need not to be specifically pleaded, may be specifically pleaded, or may not be specifically pleaded. Both B and C are correct. So here answer estoppel should be specifically pleaded. Question number 190. The rule of estoppel of tenant and of license of a person in possession is contained in. Option A, Section 116 of Evidence Act, Section 117 of Evidence Act, Section 118 of Evidence Act, Section 119 of Evidence Act. So here answer is option A, 116 of Evidence Act. 116 of Evidence Act provided that the estoppel of tenant or a license of person in possession. So here two part is important. First one is one person is tenant, T-E-N-A-N-T, tenant, and next one is licensee. Number two person is licensee. So these two persons belong to estoppel in section 116. Question number 191. Estoppel operate in case of a tenant during the continuance of tenancy and who remain in possession after the termination of tenancy by notice to quit. Both A and B, only A not B. So here answer is option C is correct. Both A and B means during of tenancy and after possession of termination of his tenancy. Question number 192. Under section 116 of Evidence Act, the tenant is estoppeled from denying the title to the property of the landlord if the tenant is denied the title of property of landlord. Option B, denying the title of property of actual owner. Both A and B, only B not A. So here not right here B, so I write here only B not A. So here answer is option A is correct here, by denying the title of property of landlord. Question number 193, the tenant or licensee tenant, both are 116. Under section 160 of 16 of Evidence Act is estoppel from denying the title of landlord during the continuance of tenancy, after creation of tenancy or license, after surrender of possession under a tenancy or license, all of the above. So here answer is option A is correct here, during the continuance of tenancy. Question number 194, under section 118, who among us the following is competent witness, child, accused, lunatic, all of the above. So it is clear here, all of the above. The competent witness under section 118 is a person who understand the question and giving the rational answer. So first here, first condition is there, understand the question and giving rational answer. If any person, either child, accused, lunatic, if he understand the question, what question is asked by the prosecution or defense, and another important point is he has the capability to give the rational answer of that question. So according to section 118, all of the above persons are competent witness. Question number 195, the person is competent to testify if they understand the question to put him, if he is able to give a rational answer to those question, if has both A and B, if has only A not B. So here answer option C is correct, if has both A and B. Question number 196, a dumbed person, very important here, dumbed person is a competent witness as provided under section 118, 119, 120. So dumbed person is provided under section 119. So option B is correct here. Husband and wife, here important word is husband and wife, both are competent witness for and against each other in civil proceeding, in criminal proceeding, both civil and criminal proceeding, neither in civil nor in criminal proceeding. So here answer both civil and criminal proceeding. The husband and wife both are competent witness for and against each other. This provision is provided under section 120. Question number 198. Section 121 of Evidence Act provided that the privilege in respect of husband and wife, judge and magistrate, affair of state, official communication. So here answer is judge and magistrate. Section 121. So 121 belong to judge oblique and magistrate, and 120 is belong to husband and wife. 120 belong to husband and wife. Question number 199, the privilege in respect of judge and magistrate under section 121 of Evidence Act relate to the question which the witness cannot be compelled to answer, the question which a witness cannot be permitted to answer, both A and B, neither A nor B. So here answer is neither A nor B. Question number 200. It is the final question of this video. The privilege under section 121 of Evidence Act is available to an arbitrator, not available to an arbitrator, may or may not be available to an arbitrator. Both B and C are correct. So here answer is the privilege under section 121, available to an arbitrator. Option A is correct. So 121 provided that the privilege to a magistrate or a judge, it also giving the privilege to the arbitrator. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please click on like button and don't forget to subscribe our channel and click on bell icon for the notification of a new videos which are we will upload it. So share this video to your friends. Thank you for watching.